Hello and welcome everybody to another Innovation Coffee Break video today from the dSPACE laboratory. My colleague Stephan and me want to show you today a real onboard charger unit that is connected to our power level hill and will be supplied by a grid emulated by the system and will charge a battery that is also emulated by the high voltage power level system. So let me start with a small introduction to the use case at all. This picture shows a grid consisting of a transformer, base load as an industry complex, long transmission lines, and a village as a base load. Outside the village, there is an electric vehicle charging via an onboard charger its high voltage battery. Of course, you could add additional systems with their control systems, each influencing the grid and thereby changing the input condition for other controllers. Here are just some examples. Overall smart grid controllers, renewable energy converters, smart houses with integrated storage and renewables, or high power charging stations. All of this is equipped with a lot of power electronics. Component development and overall system integration is a challenge where we have an answer. Here, we use hardware in the loop testing. But this typically requires models running on real-time systems. The key question is how to model all those components defining the grid and the power electronics. And of course, here comes an answer. So, there is an electric circuit, example like shown here. To simulate this, you can set up a model that describes the dynamics of the system. Or you use Simscape Electrical to benefit from the easy-to-use component-based physical modeling approach. The result is a typical sample time for the resulting model of 25 microseconds on a Scalexa real-time system. This we call EPSS processor. Even more is possible. With EPSS FPGA, a standard FPGA application is parameterized to allow sample rates faster than 2.5 microseconds. This can run, for example, on the newest FPGA boards from dSPACE. With this set of tools, standard libraries, EPSS processor, as well as EPSS FPGA, and some minor modifications by our engineering experts, almost all required component topology can be modeled and run in real time. You want to learn more about the dSPACE EPSS solution? Then have a look to further videos where the experts present the details. But now, let's have a look to an example. This slide was already used in different charging presentations. Of course, we can provide test systems for onboard chargers, including communication controllers for all charging communication standards. Today, we are focusing on the power electronic only, and therefore we connected an onboard charger to the high voltage emulation system. Because the power to be transferred is 11 kilowatt only, we are using not all the modules in the cabinet, but 5. This allows us to emulate power up to 62 kVA. The high voltage emulator represents both grid and battery. As we do not know any details of the power electronic system and inside the OBC, we can forget about it. Let's have a look now to the real demo setup where the grid is simulated by using dSPACE EPSS solution and the battery is simulated based on our ASM electric components, both running on the processor. For even higher dynamic, you could use EPSS running on a FPGA. But now, let's go and visit the real demo system.
Welcome to the live demo. I'd like to start with the introduction of the emulator rack. The emulator rack contains 17 load modules in total. Since the power requirement of the onboard charger that we want to test today is only 11 kilowatts, it is sufficient to use only 5 load modules. We use 3 load modules to simulate the AC grid voltages and 2 load modules to simulate the high voltage battery. The outputs of the load modules are then routed to the device on the test cabinet, which I will show you now. The DOT rack provides all interfaces required by the onboard charger. These are the AC grid voltages, the DC battery voltage, the water coolant, as well as some signals. There are some low voltage signals like terminal 15, terminal 30, as well as some safety signals like the high voltage interlock, and also some communication signals like CAN. These signals are simulated by the Scalexio lab box. Additionally, the rack provides some space for customer-specific measurement equipment like an oscilloscope. Now I want to show you the system running in operation. So now we want to proceed by showing you the system in operation. What you can see here is our experiment software control desk. And on this layout, you can see how the grid is modeled in our library EPSS. We have got a high voltage side and a transformer and a low voltage side. And on the low voltage side, there are some consumers connected, like also our onboard charger at the end of the line. On the bottom of the layout, you can see the high side voltage and the low side voltage and the low side current. On this layout, you can see the onboard charger on the left hand side. The battery voltage is currently 600 volt and the cable is not connected. If I want to connect the cable to the AC grid, I can do this via this button. The onboard charger now goes into the status enabled and it delivers 5 amps to the battery. On the Yokogawa power analyzer, we can see the phase voltages as well as the phase currents. Currently, the power consumption to the power grid is 3.5 kilowatt. And if I now increase the DC current, the power drawn by the grid also increases to 6.7 kilowatt. And I can see that the phase currents and phase voltages are still in phase. This means that the power factor is 1. I hope you enjoyed our today's presentation about onboard chargers in the PowerHIL system. If you have further questions, please get in contact with us. Thank you very much.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.